Following Atticus is an aspiring true story of a man and his little dog and their extraordinary friendship. It's written by a former newspaperman, Tom Ryan. Tom and his dog Atticus M. Finch join me now. Welcome to Connecticut Style. It's nice to have you both here.
Thanks for having us.
So tell me a little bit about your buddy Atticus here. What kind of dog is he?
Atticus is a nine-year-old miniature schnauzer.
And he's kind of treated like a human, isn't he?
I raised him as a friend more so than a dog.
And we should talk about the book. Let's discuss, you went on a journey together.
We did, when a friend of ours died of cancer. Hey, you gonna sleep through this?
He's really not interested in this at all, huh?
No, he's careless.
Can't be bothered by it.
When a friend of ours died of cancer, I wanted to pay tribute to her. So we tried to hike all 48 of New Hampshire's 4,000-foot mountains twice in the 90 days of winter as a fundraiser in her name.
Well, how did he do in the winter? I mean,
much better than I did.
Is that right?
He was made for it more than I am.
He has a coat, or how does he keep
warm? He has a bodysuit, and he has boots, as you can see in the cover of the book.
And we have a picture up on the screen. Looks like he's just his little ears are kind of exposed there.
That's right.
And little booties, too, I'm assuming.
Mutlucks he wears.
Okay.
And he actually has a shoe contract with him.
A shoe contract. They've done together.
Right.
Very nice. What are we looking at here?
This is a 10-mile hike over the Willy Range. And it just shows the starkness of some of the peaks we come across. Hey, Atticus, you going to sleep through this, buddy? I guess he is.
I guess so. Oh, what a beautiful shot that is.
And this is one of our beautiful foliage shots up in the White Mountains.
And you guys hike often? You still
We do. Once or twice a week. We moved up there for the ability to hike when we wanted to, where we wanted to.
Mm-hmm. And why did you just decide to write a book about all this?
I'm a writer. I used to be a newspaperman.
A newspaperman.
Wrote letters to friends, and the book was actually written, each chapter was written to a friend, you might say.
Oh, terrific.
And that's how it comes off, as a more gentle telling of the story.
How long have you and Atticus been together?
We've been together since he was 8 weeks old. He's 9 years of age. Nine
and
a half.
I don't see a leash or anything like that.
No, you wouldn't put a leash on your best friend, would you?
No, unless I was going to pull it really tight, I guess.
We were actually walking through Yale this morning, and a lot of people noticed that he was off leash, and the police were fine with it. You know?
Really?
Yeah.
Well, he's very well behaved.
Well, he is. He's better behaved than I am. One of us has to be.
Tell me what you want people to take away from the book when they read it.
It's a journey of friendship. It's a journey of growth, transformation. I think sometimes in life, or most times, we forget who we want to be when we're growing up. We have these goals, we have these ideals, and life seems kind of nice.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then we stumble, we tumble, and we get lost along the way. For me, a little dog helped me find the way back to what I always wanted to be, find a life I wanted to have, where mm-hmm. you can actually look in the mirror and be happy with yourself again.
Oh, absolutely. And anything else that you've learned from each other, I suppose?
We learn from each other every day. I mean, this book tour is something completely different. When we're in the mountains, he's much more at ease because he's an animal and he is in tune with nature. In the city, I have to take more of the lead. Let him know when he can cross the street. Let him know to be careful of other dogs. For instance, if a pit bull's walking by on a leash, you know, not all dogs are friendly.
Mm-hmm.
He can deal fine with moose and bear in the mountains, but sometimes city dogs might be different.
I see. What does he eat? Because he seems so human-like. I feel like there's just a
he eats much healthier than I do. He eats
what's
called Stellar and Chewies. Mm-hmm. It's a natural food, a raw food that's dehydrated.
I see. And Tom, any anecdotes you could share for with us?
That you might want be clean ones?
Clean ones would do. Yeah, I think so.
Well, there's so many in the book, but just this morning it was kind of fun. I mean, people don't know what to think of Atticus.
Mm-hmm.
They have no idea to see a dog that's just relaxed and in a great sense of self. We were walking across Yale's campus this morning, and a woman said, you know, dogs on our campus should be leashed.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I said, well, you know, Yale's kind of behind the times. There was a time when women weren't allowed here.
And you proved your point there.
We did. She didn't have anything else to say after that. So.
Wow, what's a typical day? You guys are always together?
We're always together. We live in a small mountain town of Jackson, New Hampshire.
Okay.
And people allow us to go where we want. They don't treat him like a dog. They greet him as if they greet any other neighbor. Hello, Atticus. Hello, Tom. We go into cafes. We go to the post office, the general store. And one of the reasons we moved up there was to have a life like that. You can't always have a life like that in the city.
Sure. I love that. What a great outlook. All right. Again, where can we find your book?
You can find it anywhere. Barnes & Noble, Amazon, independent bookstores, which we love. I do all my shopping through independent bookstores.
You do, okay.
I love supporting the little guy, and most of our tour will be going to independent bookshops.
Oh, we can see the booties now that are in the front of the book there.
That's right.
Atticus, it was really nice having you here on Connecticut Style. Thanks for being so well-behaved.
He just wants to know where the food from the last segment is.
We can find him some. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
All right, and stay with us. More Connecticut Style after the break.